Out of these troubled times, our fifth objective, a new world order can emerge, a new era, freer from the threat of terror, stronger in the pursuit of justice, and more secure in the quest for peace. I fought for my country, I've served, I've built, and I'll go from the hills to the hollows, from the cities to the suburbs, to the loneliest town on the quietest street, to take our message of hope and growth for every American, to every American. I will keep America moving forward, always forward, for a better America, for an endless, enduring dream and 1,000 points of light. After the Second World War has come of age, I've spoken of 1,000 points of light.
But there are a few little rituals that have to be observed. You might be interested to know that the only thing George Herbert Walker Bush asked me to do is to preserve the points of light.
Of 1,000 points of light.
And by the way, you know, all the rhetoric you see here, the 1,000 points of light. What the hell was that, by the way? 1,000 points of light. What did that mean? Does anyone know?
We gather in this chamber for a sacred ritual. Under the dome of this temple of democracy, the American people spoke and demanded a new dawn.
With 100% certainty, a worldwide catastrophe is headed our way. Civilization will end from this catastrophe and then be rebuilt. I know because our true history shows it has happened dozens of times. The New World Order is not what everyone thinks it is. I will explain everything so you can prepare for the catastrophe and the New World Order / Golden Age that will follow.
30 on up know exactly what's happening and they're part of it. They'll tell you that they don't, they'll tell you that I'm a liar, and you ask them to tell them what they're doing, they can't tell you, they'll tell you some bullshit about their fraternal order existing for the good of the community, and they'll point to the hospitals that they built. They can't tell you the truth because by the time they've gotten to the 30th degree of the sky is right, and this is just one organization I'm talking about, there are many under many different names, where at the highest levels, they are actually members of the Illuminati, the Illumined Ones, the Initiates, the Guardians of the Secrets of the Ages, they call themselves many different things. There's some substance to that. And they can talk all they want to, we're all going in to the new century together, whether they want to or not. Direct quote. And somebody comes up to me and says, well, how do we know which is the right way to go? I know that person has set me up to justify his bad deed. Their whole purpose throughout history has been to teach a small number of people how to become adept at controlling everyone else. By presenting their societies as desirable to the profane, so that you'll go knock on the door and say, hey, can I be a member and be initiated? With the promise of learning some great secret. What is that secret? The secret is what I have just told you this morning. The secret is how to control everybody else. And you never understand how to control everybody else until you get to the top of this pyramid of initiation, and most people never make it past the third step. All above that are carefully chosen and nurtured. And tall.
I'm sorry, I gotta see the hands. I'm not one of them.
And offer a plea to rewind the doomsday clock. And offer a plea to rewind the doomsday clock. And offer a plea to rewind the doomsday clock. And offer a plea to rewind the doomsday clock. And offer a plea. Surgery, you know, swinging steel, and really working with the railroad. There was a lot of structural gymnastics.
The result? what developers are calling a completely sustainable neighborhood.
So the concept here for the team at Hudson Yards was to create a space where New Yorkers can work, live, and play.
All in the lap of luxury, if you can afford it.
This is a three-bedroom, three-bath apartment
with condos starting at about $3 million and ranging up to $32 million. The development has drawn some criticism for being a mall for the wealthy.
As part of this development, we committed to build or preserve about 1,100 units of affordable housing.
But this new neighborhood, they say, will create new opportunities and jobs for all New Yorkers.
When you come into an office building here at Hudson Yards, you just swipe your hand and you're in. 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 You just swipe your hand and you're in.
It's a rare sight that some travel internationally to see, but today the Northern Lights could be in your own backyard. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, says Northern Lights like these seen in Finland earlier this month could be visible from several states, including from upstate New York. Scientists say the activity is expected due to a solar flare that erupted on Wednesday. The eruption caused NOAA to issue a moderate geostorm watch. Some may have seen the Northern Light last night around midnight. It's expected again tonight.
I was dreaming that I woke up due to an earthquake. Earth was shaking, floor of my house was going fall down. Went outside, seen a water coming down the street like a massive river. It's coming down my street like it was, like it's always been there. I was surprised at this because I live on a double hill, a hill on top of a hill. And it was broad daylight, I thought. Then it got dark all of a sudden. So I looked to the sky and I realized that the moon was jumping. Remember that earthquake I was talking about? Moon wasn't jumping. Earth was still shaking. Your eyes just couldn't focus on what actually was there. This object, southwest of the moon, a reddish object, a glowing reddish object. Now, it lit up again, then it went dark. It lit up again, then it went dark. Once it lit up for the final time, that was it. Fire began burning people without them even seeing fire coming from the sky. And these people, what you hear nowadays, will say meteors falling from the sky. But these are not meteors hitting people. This is just basically invisible fire. Fire you cannot see with the naked eye. But not everybody was being burned. As I looked to myself, realized I wasn't being burned, looked back to my neighbor, they were screaming in agony, but I couldn't hear their voice, I couldn't hear no sound of them screaming. So now I look back at my hands and I wasn't burning, now my heart is throbbing, pumping, but now I'm figuring out how to wake my family out of this destruction. So then I wake up.